Anyway, you know why it's a great day for the Belgians? It's Belgian Independence Day, everybody. Hey! Thank you. Yes, Belgian Independence Day. And Belgium. Belgium has given the world so much. Where you got the Belgian waffle there and the... Well, that's an excellent thing, the Belgian waffle. That's awesome. Although over there, they don't call it the Belgian waffle. They just call it the waffle. It's like if you go to England and ask for an English muffin, they're like, I'm sorry, I don't know what you're talking about. They don't have English muffins in England. They couldn't eat them anyway. Because if they've all got tiny little mouths. Tiny little mouths, won't it? What's that? No, we don't. I can't fit a muffin in here, mate. No. Have you got any peas? What about some peas? I like to eat peas and maybe some plankton. That's what I eat. Lovely.
Plankton, yeah, I said it. But Belgium. The Smurfs are from Belgium. Remember the Smurfs? They were the little blue guys that lived in a forest. There was a village, it was a little village of Smurfs. There was 50 men, Smurfs, and one girl. It's no wonder they were all blue, really. All right, that's enough. Don't start that nonsense. I'm going to talk about Belgium. I'm not going to talk about that. Belgium's a nice... It's a nice place that... a lot of people go to Belgium. It's the place they go to... It's a nice place, and they go there on the way to another place that they're really going to spend more time at. It's kind of the Jennifer Aniston of countries, basically. It's... things out. I'm just saying some things are like other things to help you visualize what Belgium is like. Oh, no, I'm the bad guy. Do we have a map of Belgium, do we? There you are, Belgium. That's the Bruno and Sibora, Luxembourg, New Jersey. What is that? Is that the country of Luxembourg? I don't know if that map's up to date. Basically, Belgium is the Canada of France, or it's the Mexico of the Netherlands, really. And in parts of Belgium, they still speak Flemish. Which is their language. It's based entirely on phlegm. That's why it's called... It is. It's a, you know... That's how you say Happy Independence Day in Belgium. You go. Flemish is a language that's been dying out since the invention of antibiotics. But it's anyway. It's Independence Day in Belgium on this day in 1831. I'm turning into someone who talks like that. 1831. My mouth is getting smaller and smaller. And soon I'll be confined to a diet of solely peas. On this day in 1831, Belgium declared independence from France and Holland and Luxembourg. And there was a lot of... And there was a Spanish dude as well who was ordering Belgian peasants around for no reason. He was like, okay, everybody, move over here. Everybody, move over here. He was a gay Spanish dude. What I'm trying to say is that in the 1830s, there were several countries that laid claim to the territory that's now known as Belgium. And because back then, Belgium was a kind of the timeshare of oppression. What France would say, we will exploit them during the summer, the Dutch get them in the winter, and spring they're everybody's bitch, and then we all sort of... Really, they've been ruled by so many people, the Belgians, their coat of arms says, clean up after you're done. That's what it says. But the Belgians don't care. And you know why? They have a secret. A wonderful secret. A terrifying and beautiful secret. They have the best beer in the world. Oh, yes, they do. I've been there. They do. The beer I drank in Belgium was a beer called Duvel, which is Belgian. It means devil. It is Satan's beer.
It is the beer from hell.
This beer is, and I'm not kidding, 170% alcohol. Yeah, take that, girls gone wild. When I was there drinking this Duvel beer, even as I was a chronic blackout alcoholic at the time, and I'm thinking as I'm drinking this beer, this is not safe. This is not safe. There's over 800 types of beer made in Belgium. I know, I drank them all in one night. I woke up in a brothel in Amsterdam. I worked there for 6 months until I sobered up. Best damn blackout of my life. Now, In Belgium, the monks brew the beer. They've been doing it since the Middle Ages, which I think is a great assignment if you're a monk. Like, if you're a monk and you go to study in a monkle school, if you go to monkle college or something, I don't know. Anyway, if you go to study monkleness, and that's what you want to get, is the beer brewing assignment, because the guy comes out, all right, you get to copy the Bible out using a big feathery pen. You get stabbed by Vikings and you go and make some beer. We've run out of time, haven't we? I was going to talk about Jean-Claude Van Damme, though. He's from Belgium. He's the muscles from Brussels. I could talk about him after the break, couldn't I? But I'm not going to. I'm going to talk about him now. You'll have to wait for the commercials. No, it's all right. Don't clap that, because then they really have to wait for the commercials, and they... I don't have that kind of power. I'm not really a rebel, I'm just a whore for CBS. All right, Belgium. Oh, Jean-Claude Van Damme, that's what we're going to talk about, the thinking man Steven Seagal. He was called the Muscles from Brussels when he was doing his thing. He was the Muscles from Brussels. I used to have a name like that when I first came to America. I was the Hot Mess from Loch Ness. I know. Do you know what else is from Belgium? Brussels sprouts, which are... They're delicious. They're like miniature cabbages. And some people don't like them because they resemble the Incredible Hulk's testicles. But I like them. What I like to do... Because he takes steroids. You know he takes steroids. So what I like to do is I buy Brussels sprouts, right? I go to the store, I get Brussels sprouts, and then I take off my pants and I hold the Brussels sprouts and I'm like, who's the Hulk now, bitch?